Good evening and welcome. You're watching the News Hour Agenda. I'm Padmaja Joshi. 5 days and we get you part three of the drug dossier in the Riya Chakravarti Sushant Singh Rajput case. Chats by the accused number one in this case and those in Sushant's inner circle, actively seeking out drugs and talking about the consumption of drugs. Times Now has in its possession now 48 new messages between members of Sushant's innermost circle, including Riya Chakravarti, that speak of getting doobies, a street slang for cannabis cigarettes, among other things. In addition to doobies, they say that they are using drugs like AK-47 and Blueberry Kush, but also helpfully exchange pictures for ready reference. Let me now get you the details of this cannabis circle, as it were, that was working, that was in play around Sushant Singh Rajput. Specific mentions made by these individuals about drugs in WhatsApp chats. And these are chats from as recently as 2019. Starting with the 30th of July 2019, when Riya Chakravarti herself says, doobie required. She is asking for it in first person. Strange, considering that she has claimed, I have never asked for, bought or taken drugs. Then there is Riya's friend Ayush, who replies, rolling a doobie. A week earlier, on the July 21st, 2019, the same Ayush had told another friend, take doobies when you go. Person number three in this circle is Siddharth Pithani, who on the 5th of August 2019 asked Samuel Miranda, SSR has the doobs, right? Person number five is Shovik Chakravarti, Riya's brother. On July 21, he messaged a common friend with instructions, tell Ayush to get doobies. And finally, person number seven is Samuel Miranda, who seems to be actively coordinating for the drugs with everyone. On the 14th of August last year, he tells someone in Team SSR that only one doob is left and they should call Ashok for some more stuff. On the 27th of August, his hunt seems to have paid off because he not just claims to have scored AK-47 and Blueberry Kush, but also sends across a picture of that drug. Now, all of this is going to make the going extremely tough for Riya Chakravarti. Questioned by the CBI today for over 10 hours, she's also facing an FIR by the Narcotics Control Bureau. Three major facts emerge from these chats that directly contradict the claims of innocence that Riya has made so far. First point, she said that she has never procured or consumed drugs. But the chat from July 30, 2019 show her asking her friend Ayush at 11:42 a.m. doobie required. Same day, 4:46 p.m. she asks Ayush, do we have a doob? To which he replies, rolling and getting. Her second claim was that Sushant was habituated to marijuana and it was she who was trying to wean him off it. However, the chats show that far from discouraging the entry of drugs into Sushant's house, she was the one coordinating it. And finally, she said that her brother Shovik was merely Sushant's friend and is being unnecessarily vilified, except that these chats show Shovik saying at least once on the 21st of July, reach soon guys and tell Ayush to get doobies. The question that now remains is, can Riya Chakravarti explain these drug chats when clearly they fly in the face of claims of innocence that she made earlier?
News Hour at 10, debate number 1 on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Joining us on the debate, we have Shweta Shalini, spokesperson of the BJP, director and a friend of Sushant Singh Rajput, Roshan Gary, advocate Chandni Shah, political analyst Tanvi Pruthi, advocate Surinder Chauhan. My first question is to political analyst Sundar Balakrishnan. Here you had Riya Chakravarti yesterday, Mr. Balakrishnan, saying, I have never taken drugs. And then you have a chat from last year where she says, doobies required. Tanvi Pruthi, if you can take that question, doobies required. If somebody has never taken or procured drugs, what do you need doobies for? Doobies required. Do we have doobies? What does this say, Tanvi Pruthi? All right, Surinder Chauhan, I'm hoping at least you can hear me because clearly neither can Sundar Balakrishnan nor can Tanvi Pruthi. Yes, Mr. Chauhan.
Now, what does it reflect? Do be required. All right, if I go by your chat, do be required for whom? A, B, C, D. Now, what is the relevance of these chats in the present context of SSR, FIR, investigated by the CBI?
I don't know. You tell me, sir, because yesterday
which
we
angle?
Had the same
now you are
lady
correlating.
Say, I've never taken drugs. I have never asked for drugs. And there she is in a chat saying, do be required.
I'm going a step further. Suppose even if she's consuming drugs, is there any correlation with the SSR FIR?
Yes, sir. For one, the veracity of her claims is under the cloud. If her one claim has been shown up as false, the veracity of all her claims will then come into question. The veracity of what she is saying is now questioned.
You see the WhatsApp chat. You see the WhatsApp chats have no evidentiary values. They can only have a leading thing.
Sir,
they can lead to certain kind of investigation by the CBI.
On this N number of times.
So let's
that
await,
be decided
for the CBI
by the court and it will be decided by the CBI. I want to ask you, as somebody who was saying that there is only a vilification campaign, there is no evidence at all, what does this chat tell you? As opposed to a lady who has said, I have never taken drugs, I have never spoken of drugs, I was trying to get Sushant off drugs, and here she is asking for a drug.
So do be required doesn't mean that she is consuming drugs.
What
do
does
be
it
required
mean?
All right.
What does
do
it
be
mean?
Required maybe from A, B, C, D, somebody
mean?
Else?
That you get a doobie and
she,
then you put it
she,
in your
she may
room.
Be felicitating somebody.
Felicitating
she may be
somebody?
Felicitating somebody.
What is this a
she may be felicitating somebody.
The one
who
that
are you
was
felicitating with a doobie, sir? What kind of felicitation ceremonies do you go for?
You see, that Rhea can explain better to the investigating agencies.
No, of course she will. That she will have to because she will be questioned. But as somebody who was very vocal about claims of innocence, I am now bringing facts back to you.
So it can only lead to a lead.
You said that this was a vilification
campaign.
These
chats can only give a leading thing
to you. And now seeking a logical explanation. That's all. I'm not making you answer on her behalf, certainly
vilification campaign that media...
I am just putting a fact on the table.
Vilification campaign is that on a national channel, you people are maligning a woman who is not guilty. She has
sir,
not been proven guilty by
am
a court
of law. Am I saying anything other than
she
the
is
fact
presumed to be
that
innocent.
The lady was asking for doobies? That's it, period. I'm not saying that this reflects on her in a certain way or not. I'm talking about a fact.
Not guilty.
And just by the way, it's a crime in the country. That's all I'm saying.
If it is, well, one minute. Something is crime in NDPS Act. She will face the music, but at all, you are maligning her and
how?
Correlating her character with the SSR.
How is this maligning?
Because you are vilification.
How am I
vilifying? Yes, vilification campaign is.
How is it
vilification campaign
that
is that she
how is it
vilifying is that vilifying is that you people are saying.
You don't
yes, one minute, listen to
word.
Me now.
You said she was not guilty.
You people.
How is it vilification? Just forget for the sorry. How is this vilification? Explain it to me.
It was she, yes. She, you are saying that she is the one who was making Sushant to have drugs.
I'm saying no such thing. I'm just saying
and
that she asked
giving,
for a doobie.
She was,
as opposed
way, was
to when she had said earlier
minute.
That I have never had any contact with drugs, period. Don't tell me what I'm saying. I am saying that as opposed to what Ms. Chakravarti said yesterday,
a person,
she can be seen in these chats actively asking for drugs. Shweta Shalini, how is this vilification campaign?
I take it on me.
There are two things, Padmaja. I want Surendra Chauhan ji to answer this one simple question. Does he agree that she lied on public TV, on national TV? She plainly lied because she primarily said that I have had no contact with drug at all.
It is your perception.
Yes, according to Sunil, she might be facilitating.
Madam, it is your perception. It is your perception. Unless these chats are proven, one, unless the leads given by these chats are proven, you cannot say.
I don't want to be a judge like you to say that she is not guilty. After Rajdeep Sardesai, it is you, Surendra ji, who has...
No, you cannot, you cannot blame her. Even you cannot blame her. Even you cannot blame her that she is guilty.
I am saying...
So, which is why I am saying... Stop.
I asked to you, Mr. Chauhan,
try to respect the women. She's also a daughter of somebody.
You can decide right at the beginning that Sushant committed suicide, but even based on these chats, one cannot surmise that the lady was asking for drugs. Roshan Gary.
Yes. Every bit of the interview she said is full of lie. From the drugs to he being claustrophobic. He is getting scared when he gets onto the flight. We have released so many videos of his. You can go and see since yesterday where he is taking off on a flight. He loves to be a pilot. It was his dream. How can he be scared of the flight? What a big liar she is. She said he used to feel claustrophobic. The boy who got into the NASA capsule, how can he be claustrophobic? She is a big liar.
Sundar Balakrishnan, and you know, everyone says these are assumptions. You are only making assumptions. You are only making up things against. And now, in addition to messages, there are actual pictures. You had Samuel Miranda on the 27th of August writing saying, I have AK-47 and blueberry kush. And for good measure, he also sends across a picture. Now, what is left to the imagination, Sundar Balakrishnan?
Yeah, Patmaja.
And yesterday we were told, I have nothing to do with drugs. I'm ready for a blood test. My brother's got nothing to do with it. Sushant was the one who was consuming drugs. I was trying to take him off it. Does this look like someone who's dissuading Sushant, saying, hey, don't do drugs?
Yeah, let me answer. And request you, please don't allow others to interfere whatever I'm saying. First thing is, there is complete report to the doctors, which is being police, and that is with the CBI, which says that he was undergoing depression and he had panic attacks. And he had also visited Hinduja Hospital on November 27th. And there were several visits that he had got to the doctors, and there are reports which
so
are...
So what's that got to do with getting drugs into the house? What does that have to do with getting drugs into the house?
I will explain. See, I'll make one statement that makes everything clear. A person who gets intoxicated by another person unknowingly will sooner or later come to know that he is intoxicated either the same day or the next day. Okay? This is a simple thing. He was not a minor. He is a major. He must know that, you know, somebody is intoxicated.
Sir, what is your point? Are you saying that Sushant needed drugs and Riya was facilitating it?
He's going round the bush.
What is your point? I am showing you chats where somebody is talking about drugs. You're telling me about Hinduja Hospital. What's the connection?
As per his ex-bodyguard, Mushtaq, he said very clearly he was used to taking charas. There is a statement by this ex-bodyguard. And third thing, what I am saying is, now this BJP guys are talking of this drug. I want to ask you, what is the Sandeep Singh role here? He is a person who was involved in producing Modi biopic.
Sir, what is your point? I am asking you about this chat. You are saying that he was in hospital. You are saying that he is not a minor. Are you trying to say that Riya was only fulfilling a demand that Sushant made? Is that what you are trying to say? That Sushant was asking for drugs and Riya was merely giving it to him?
I'm saying he had panic attacks, he was going to the depression, he was addicted to drugs. I'm telling you.
So Riya was supplying it to him?
Depression, all this.
So Riya is supplying it to him? He was addicted? He was addicted, so Riya was just supplying it to him? And no, so was her brother.
Can you prove that Sushant was addicted?
I can prove to you at least that Riya was asking for drugs. And that is right here in black and white. How can you prove that Sushant was addicted? How can you prove? What is your proof, sir? Chandni Shah, what is your proof, Mr. Balakrishnan?
You are saying
I have one limited proof to show that Riya Chakravarti and Shovin Chakravarti were in possession of drugs. Now, what is your proof to show that Sushant was the one who was seeking out these drugs? What is your proof?
That is because he had gone a treatment to three doctors and the doctor.
Okay, so Chandni Shah, here the argument being made is that he was having these anxiety attacks. Riya was just helping him calm down and stay calm.
Padmaja, first, let's also see to the fact that the interview, that the PR stunt interview that was conducted with a very, very infamous journalist yesterday. In that same interview, she denied the fact that she had such conversations with Jaya Saha or with Gaurav Arya or with anyone. And today, Jaya Saha has confessed to ED that yes, she did inform Riya about how to take the CBD oil. So over here, this PR stunt interview with Riya stands null and void, right? It stands incorrect. She lied on national television that she never had that conversation.
Tanvi Priti, you know, nobody is answering the three direct contradictions. All I'm saying is, I am not making anything up. I am just holding Ms. Chakravarti's word against what is being seen in these chats. That's all. She's saying, I was trying to wean Sushant off. She's saying, Shovik didn't have anything to do with it. She's saying, I have never taken drugs. And these conversations show otherwise, Tanvi Priti. Don't they? Would you agree that these chats contradict what Riya Chakravarti said? Let me just tell you a brief idea
of the NCRB Act and how it works, okay?
Sir, can you please answer my question to you is, do these chats contradict what Riya Chakravarti has said? Do these chats contradict what Riya has said? That's all.
Can I make a point?
Absolutely. Can I come in, please?
Ma'am, I'm asking you only. Do these chats contradict what Riya Chakravarti has said?
Yes, let me speak on it. No, if the NCRB has evidence, if these stats are correct, then NCRB must have arrested her immediately, because the act, if a person is in possession of these kinds of drugs, then that person is to be arrested immediately. And let me remind you that in criminal law, under IPC, the burden of proof is on the prosecution to prove that benefit of doubt in the case. But in case of NDPS Act, let me remind you, the burden of proof is on the accused. That Riya has to prove if she was consuming these kinds of drugs, she has to prove beyond all doubt.
Okay, Shweta Shalini, inaction so far shows that these chats mean nothing. Then why is the NCRB not acting? Why is the NCRB not acting?
That's what I'm asking. That means these chats are false, or these evidences have no meaning at all.
You're saying the chats are false, Shweta Shalini?
Absolutely not. I think the NCRB will act. They have just come into action. There is a certain procedure that CBI is following. And please do not forget, there are three kinds of actions which are being taken. One is the financial angle of the fraud. The second is the murder angle. And now this is a new angle which has surfaced. So I think to balance these three angles and to finish the three... Exactly. So this is where I feel it is taking time. I am sure that there is some relevant information that people have, and you will soon see arrests happening.
Okay, does that satisfy you, Surinder Chauhan? I mean, the evidence has only just emerged now. Are you satisfied or you want immediate arrest?
Nobody can be arrested based on WhatsApp messages. No one can be arrested. If you have to arrest a person, the person has to be found in possession of the drug. Only then he can be arrested.
So which means actual possession of the drug.
Found in possession, cannot be arrested under narcotics.
Well, they will look for further evidence. evidence, which is the reason why now there is a search on also of the people who've been mentioned in these chats. People like Gaurav Arya, people like this Ashok, who the chat say is going to give you other stuff. But the point is, sir, purely going by these contents, if there's one thing that one can surmise, is that the claim of innocence seems to be very doubtful now. Won't you agree to that, Sundar Balakrishnan?
Cannot be arrested.
Sir, you will make all points except the very basic question I'm asking. That to say that I'm completely innocent, I have got nothing to do with drugs, is falsified by these chats.
No, but by that, then let her prove.
Of course, we will wait for the proof. I am just coming back to you with some facts and asking you that your vehement claims of innocence earlier, they seem to be belied. That's all I'm saying.
The debate is whether, why they realize.
Padmaja, if you ask me theoretically, the whole film world is into drugs. Okay? So I cannot tell you whether Ria has taken the drugs or not. I cannot tell you. Based on what the messages, I cannot tell you. These are just messages.
Roshan doesn't agree with you. She's in the film world and she doesn't agree with you. Roshan.
Whether she had really purchased it, whether there was a financial transaction.
I belong to the film world and the entire film world, just because of Ria Chakravarti, is not full of drug addicts. Sorry. I do not agree to you at all.
Have you seen?
I belong to this wall.
I belong to it. Have you seen?
I have people around me. I have never, forget drugs. I have never used a smoke also, not a cigarette also, in my 25 years of career. What are you talking?
We don't want to know about
just
you.
Because,
we don't want to know about you.
That
we don't
doesn't
want
mean
to know
that
about
only
you.
The, you are talking about my industry. My industry is not full of drug addicts. Just because people like Reels have come there and they are supplying to the people and they are ruining the people's lives and they have ruined the life of people like Sushant Singh Rajput.
You know,
and people like Reels should be definitely sued.
You know, earlier, Mr. Balakrishnan, you had Ria Chakravarti saying that I've got nothing to do with drugs, but Surinder Chauhan, now that Ria Chakravarti is shown asking for drugs, Mr. Balakrishnan says, everyone in the film world does drugs. It's full of it. Everyone is doing it. You know, it's to be found in every street corner in Mumbai. But how does one explain then that Ria's brother also is having a conversation where he says, reach soon, guys, and tell Ayush to get doobies. Now, you can't even put it down to the film world and says everyone who's in Bollywood is doing drugs. What explains this? These are all people, Mr. Chauhan, who are around Sushant. And who all said that Sushant was the one who was doing drugs. We had nothing to do with it. And yet, month on month, they are talking about consumption of drugs and solicitation of drugs. Surinder Chauhan, where does that claim of innocence go now?
I disagree with the statement of Mr. Balakrishnan that entire film world is in the drugs. Drugs are not easily accessible in anywhere in the part of the country. Narcotic Control Bureau is on a vigil. Police are working day and night. If at all somebody is having drugs, the law is NDPS Act is there. And NDPX Act clearly says whoever sells, having in possession.
Mr. Chauhan,
so chats,
I know all of that. Get to the point. My question
on,
to you is different. Why is it that all
guilty.
These people around Sushant who said Sushant was the one doing drugs are now having conversations about drugs? How is one then going to explain to the family which said that they were the ones plying him with drugs?
It is for them to explain.
I will tell you. I will answer
this. It is for them to explain. I am no one to explain that. If any were surrounding him, saying and making a claim that he was on drug, so let them explain. If Ria who was close to him, who was his girlfriend, they were living in partners, if she's saying, you have to admit that.
Absolutely. So now you agree. Now you agree that yesterday what Ria Chakravarti said about having nothing to do with drugs, that was false. You will admit that, Mr. Chauhan?
No, I'm not here to comment on that. I neither admit or nor deny.
Of course, great. Because you were quick to say that Sushant had committed suicide, but today when you are faced with facts, you say, I neither admit nor deny. All right, Sundar Balakrishnan, will you admit or deny?
What?
That the fact Ria said, we have got nothing to do with drugs, Sushant was the only one who was involved, was false. That claim was false.
The depression, let me tell you, the depression and the anxiety come
He was not in depression. Just because Ria says he was in depression, that doesn't mean he was into depression.
Anxiety, the moment he doesn't get the drugs on a regular basis, he'll get Rishan. As per his ex-bodyguard, he was having chorus.
Mr. Balakrishnan, first of all, if somebody is in depression, you don't ply them with drugs. That is why you have a psychiatrist who will give you prescribed medicines. And even going by your account, he did have prescription drugs. And now you're trying to justify, now you're trying to reason with this and say, oh, this was only an attempt to try and get him to relax. Shweta Shalini, the point of the matter is that this, according to the law, is illegal. Shweta Shalini.
So Padmaja, my simple question to Sundar ji is, if everyone seems to be having drugs, what is the government doing? Are they sleeping? You have your government in the state of Maharashtra.
Second,
very, very clearly, he lied on TV and you have Surendra ji coming here and saying that you are vilifying a woman.
Where she
is someone's daughter. Sushant was also someone's son. And she vilified him after his death. Every bit of the interview was scripted. It is justice versus propaganda. And unfortunately, media fraternity is a part of this propaganda.
Because you know, Tanvi Pruthi, when you say that I had no access to drugs and that turns out to be fake, your similar claim where Riya Chakravarti also said Surendra Chauhan that Sushant was the one who's depressed, one doesn't know whether you should trust that at all. Maybe that's just as false.
No, you have to trust it. You have to admit it.
How
you
can
have
you
to,
trust
if,
it?
If a woman who is saying
how
with her him and saying that my boyfriend, my boyfriend, my man is in depression, and you see, 1 minute, a woman is staying with him. He is her man, and she's saying that my man is in depression. To whom you will believe? A father who is staying in Patna, a sister is staying in States, a sister who is staying in Panchkula,
or a sister staying in Mumbai. Difficulty believing someone whose other statements turn out to be false. If somebody says statement A and it turns out to be false, how will you trust statement B, Mr. Chauhan?
Prima facie, you have to believe her. Leaving relationship is a relationship of husband and wife.
I am not commenting about the relationship. Of course, it's a perfectly legitimate relationship. My question to you is different. My question is about how trustworthy is what Ms. Chakravarti says.
You have to believe her at this threshold.
I would like to add one point over here at Padmaja, which is not being talked about, which is not being talked about since a long time. Surendra ji, explain to me something. You are talking about she being a live-in partner of Sushant Singh Rajput, and she must be knowing much more things about him. I agree to that. Tell me something. Why was she taking cuts and kickbacks from Quant Talent Management? All right, from the commissions that Quant Talent Management was having.
Okay, let's leave that for another day because this is not about, you know, surmises and rhetoric. Today was a very specific question based on very specific conversations that have been accessed. And remember all of this while today there was a questioning by the CBI. And subsequently, there will be questioning by the Narcotics Control Bureau as well. And this is just to give context for the kind of investigation that Riya Chakravarti, Shovik Chakravarti are likely to be subjected to. Thanks very much, all gentlemen, Tanvi Pruthi, Chandni Shah and Shweta Shalini for joining me.